I'm Archdeacon Bill Gray, and I'm the priest of the Anglican parish of Bob Cage in Dunsford and Burnt River. I'm leading in the service of morning prayer from the sanctuary of St. John's Anglican Church in Dunsford. On this, the sixth Sunday of Easter, as we reflect upon the 17th chapter of the book of the Acts of the Apostles and also the Gospel of John, our theme is the altar to an unknown God that the Apostle Paul discovers in the ancient city of Athens at the Areopagus. As always, many of you have had this service sent to you by email, and I encourage you to print it in advance and follow along. And if you are so moved, join in the congregational responses as indicated by the bold print. For others, you'll find this service online, or perhaps you have your own prayer book for the Book of the Alternative Services of the Anglican Church of Canada, beginning on page 98. Let's have a moment of silent prayer. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
He gave us new life and hope by raising Jesus from the dead.
Rejoice then, even in your distress.
We shall be counted worthy when Christ appears.
God has claimed us as his own.
He called us from our darkness into the light of his day.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
The Invitatory is Christ our Passover for this continued Easter season. Alleluia, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. A reading from the book of the Acts of the Apostles, the 17th chapter, beginning at the 22nd verse. Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with this inscription, to an unknown God. What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you, the God who made the world and everything in it, he who is the Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor, he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being. And even some of your own poets have said, for we too are his offspring. For since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed. And of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. Hear what the Spirit is saying to us now.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Saint John.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me, and those who love me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. This is the Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us join together in saying an affirmation of faith, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our Easter intercessory prayers, each petition of which ends in the phrase, "Hear us, Lord of glory." In joy and hope, let us pray to the source of all life, saying, hear us, Lord of glory, that our risen Savior may fill us with joy of his holy and life-giving resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory,
that he may reveal the light of his presence to all in need, particularly the victims, families and friends of the mass shootings in Nova Scotia. We pray for those armed forces personnel lost in the crashed Canadian military helicopter that went down in the Mediterranean, asking that God may comfort those grieving families, our community, province and nation. We pray for all who have died, particularly as a consequence of the COVID-19 virus, and that God may comfort the bereaved. We pray for all the sick, the weak, and the dying, that they may be comforted and strengthened. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That people living alone, and particularly during this time in isolation, may find fresh strength in the Easter Gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may grant us humility to be subject to one another in Christian love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may provide for those who lack food, work, or shelter, particularly praying for community food banks, for giving thanks for those who donate, and praying for those who have need and receive. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That frontline responders, volunteers, and all caregivers may be strengthened through all the earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
That he may send the fire of the Holy Spirit upon us, upon our bishops, Andrew and Priscilla, upon our priests and all clergy, asking your prayers for myself in this ministry at this time. And we pray for all parish leaders, church members, and upon all his people, that we may bear faithful witness to his resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
We remember those of our parish who have recently died, especially Audrey, Miriam, Ruth, Tammy, Bob, and Jeff, and we especially pray for their loved ones in their bereavement. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
And now we listen to the collect for the sixth Sunday of Easter. Merciful God, you have prepared for those who love you riches beyond imagination. Pour into our hearts such love toward you, that we, loving you above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with those whom you love this day and forevermore. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord makes his face to shine on us and be gracious to us. The Lord looks upon us with favor and grants us his peace, now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.